You should probably catch me back another batch of No Cap. Today we got two truths, horror story, anime. Before you get into the video, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share to be No Cap, bro. True dad. Okay, we got true dad
it's
first.
I'm Chaudhry, you know, and I'm from India.
Okay.
This is not a horror story, but an emotional one. This all started this year when my maternal grandfather got sick one day. My mom and dad went to meet him.
But what's a maternal?
He died. After that, my father gets symptoms of COVID and headed home. So, me and my brother were staying with my grandmother. After coming home,
damn, that's a rough
so much fever and cough that he has to be admitted to the hospital.
Damn.
He stayed there for 5 days and died on April
3rd. Damn, bro. RIP to your grandpa and your dad, bro.
Fainted. But days after that, we started to get our normal life back. But one night, my father came into my dream, and he was in the car with me. We were driving somewhere. Then the car stopped to a dark bridge. I see him get out of the car and start going somewhere. I immediately stopped him and asked him where he was going, and he said he didn't know. And then I became aware that this was the last time we would see each other, so we both hugged each other and started crying. I Damn. Said he had a dangerous type of coronavirus. Then I asked him what we do in our life. He answered, saying that he didn't know. Then I noticed a man standing behind him. I asked my father who he was. My father said that the man was trying to take him somewhere. I cried some more, and then we said our final goodbyes.
What the
After
fuck?
That, I never saw my
That's
dad in my
That's a fucked
dreams.
Up dream, bro.
I really miss him. I know he will never come back. So the only message I want to give you is to try to spend time with your parents and siblings, because they could vanish at any time.
RIP, bro, for real, for real. You got break in, bro. Damn, that shit. You could have put, you know what I'm saying, a different one first, bro. Fucked up the vibe from the jump.
My name is Natalia, and this experience still traumatizes me to this day. Me and my parents moved into a new house, and the house was barely built. So my dad and his friends went to go paint the walls of our house. And my mom was back in our old house getting our things. And I was at the new house taking care of my little sister. At night, my parents had to go to the store to get more paint, and they told me to stay home to take care of my little sister, and then left. My little sister was in the living room sleeping, and I went to my room. I was tired and totally forgot that my sister was in the living room.
So forgot I about sleep. Your sister, bro.
But while I'm half asleep, I
hear
oh
shit!
I get up quickly and hide in my closet.
The fuck about your sister, bro?
My baby sister was down there.
No fucking way.
I quietly went down the stairs and snuck into the living room. Thankfully, my baby sister was still sleeping, so I picked her up. But the moment I grabbed her, I heard something coming through the kitchen. I slowly went over to check. In the kitchen, there was a man going through our trash can and eating everything in it.
So get out, bro. Get out.
He turned around to look at me, and I ran up the stairs and went to my closet. I was crying as I stayed in there, and I heard footsteps coming from outside my room.
Should have left when you could, bro.
Don't be afraid of me. I just wanted to eat. But now, you're my next meal.
Oh, hell no.
I stayed silent and put my baby sister down. Then I got a hammer that was in my closet and went out. The man was outside the door, and I hit him in his head 14
times. The fuck?
Times.
Damn, you counted?
My baby sister crying.
Damn.
I got her and went outside, then sat there with my bloody hands and shirt.
Call the cops. Call your mom.
5 minutes go by, and my parents come home. They asked me what was going on, and still in shock, I told them everything. They called the cops, and they took him to the hospital, but on the way to the hospital, he died. I told them it was self-defense, and a few days later, we sold the house. 2 years later, the news came up.
That's cap, bro. A few days later, not sold the house. The investigation was still going on, bro.
The house that I killed the man in. A girl's body was found in the bathtub with her legs cut off. And I wonder, what if I was that girl?
That's fucked up, bro, both them stories.